You've got a cold heart and a cold archer. Got a bottle you with, but I got no proof that you showed up tonight in that dress.
What's up, boys? How y'all doing? Late night tonight, man. We are. Hell, what are we doing? We're playing week 9. Colorado Buffalo's trying to get bowl eligible, man. We're 5-3. We are definitely on the struggle bus, and it's not going well. But hopefully we'll get something going here where we can maybe get a dub. I mean, right now, I don't know, man. Like I said, we've been struggling. So what we're going to do is we're going to kick this off and hopefully win, man. Check out our uniform options, see if we gonna change anything up. I like the white socks with the black. This looks sharp to me. All right, so there it is. We'll get the... Where's the Buffs offense? There it is. Defense gonna do its thing. Let's go, boys. Let's go. Come on. Gotta get a win. What's up, rapper? What's up, boys? How we doing tonight? Things good? I got the lights down low. Too bright. Might be too bright. Yeah, that's way too bright. That's scary bright. Let me put like a shade over that or something. All right, boys. Let's see if we can get a win. Man, our offense is one of the worst in college football.
Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. There is immense conference pride in the Big Ten. No conference I can think of has more games where they play for trophies, whether it's Paul Bunyan's axe, a little brown jug, an old oaken bucket. Somebody's always playing for something, but most of all, they're playing for pride. A great matchup coming in the Big Ten. We've done,
man,
all we can do.
We are
here.
Third. A legend, right? A legend, huh? Something. Get me going through this one. Man, I hope we get a lot of people in here tonight. Still hope.
Hey,
2,334 feet above sea level at Folsom Field in Boulder, Colorado. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
All right, another night game? Man, we are playing night game after night game after night game. Let's go. What's good, Sooners? What's good? Well, hopefully these Buffs can get a win, man. Let's hope. Lost a heartbreaker last night to Nebraska. And now we're trying to get this thing, this ship turned, man. Can y'all hear me out there? Rapper, can you hear me? Sooners, can you hear me?
Excellent kick.
Oh, he's not even gonna turn that out.
It goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Final game for these seniors on their home field. Some will get to the next level, play some more football. Others, they'll be putting the helmet on for the final time.
Well, Sooners, it depends. What you're kind of looking for in your dynasty, man. I started this dynasty out with Air Force and built them into a power. Oh, shit. We got one of these offenses today. This is going to be a problem. Very static. I bet it's because my fan is on. Hold on a second. Let me know sooner if that's better. Iowa State runs the flex bone. That's going to be a problem for me. I am not good at defending that. Fullback, just pushing for 10. Let's go.
How would you like to be a defensive back?
Come on.
And see this guy rumbling at you with a full head of steam.
All right. Iowa State, I got to get out of this defense. All right, so we're going to go. I'm going to go goal line with speed. See ya.
From their own.
What's up, DJ? I was playing Call of Duty with some buddies. So we, option. They're all over it. Let's go. Sooners, I'd pick a team. Like, I have some rules when I do my dynasties. They have to have Nike uniforms, have to have a cool stadium. Otherwise, I don't mess with them. Well, I figured, you know. Picked the wrong gap. I'd pick someone like Southern Miss. What's up, Carlos? It's been a while since I've seen you in here, man. False start. Let's go. Buffering issues. I shouldn't have any buffering issues tonight. Hold on, sir.
Situation, and if someone makes a mental mistake, it makes your blood boil if you're a
Bushing, buffering issues might be on your end. I don't know why it's buffering. Alright, hold on. It shouldn't be buffering. My computer says that everything is zero drop frames.
Really centered around
I don't know, man. Hopefully it gets better. Kane, I saw like a fumble return for a touchdown by Virginia Tech. That's all I saw, though. It's buffering for everybody. Computer. I'm looking at it right now. Zero dropped frames. Your stream quality is good. My computer's working at 37%. So...
Second down, 7 yards to go.
Well, we lost to Nebraska. That's why the Nebraska game was not kind to us.
And they make the stop at the 33-yard line. He gets another set of downs, and more importantly, opens up...
Oh, Sooners, if you go with USC, that's too easy, man. You gotta pick a team that's hard. Challenge yourself. Oh, he's got slant. Hits Brown, thrown behind him a little bit there, but he gets 7 yards. Depends on whenever time that stuff gets going there, Kane. If it's during the day, I'm usually teaching online classes or I'm out on the water. That's a pick. Oh, he comes back to it. Nice play there by McDaniel. Let's go. Cal Bears ain't bad Sooners. They're not a bad school. They got a lot of uniform options. So that's kind of cool. Hopefully things have buffered themselves free. Oh man, they're blitzing. This could be a big one. This could be a big one. Get out. Oh, Mac trips on that damn tight end every time.
Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen, maybe hit the tight end on a short
play. All right, second down and 15. Just a bit much to handle at this moment. VMI or Yale?
He scrambled.
Ooh, Brown tried to break free, could not do it. Only gets 4 on the play. Oh, boy. Hokie for life. So are you a big-time Hokie fan? Like your name says? Like, what is your all-time favorite Hokie memory that you were alive for? Am I a teacher? Well, sort of. I'm a retired teacher. I own a business now, so. But I do some. Oh, I can't. It's so slow.
Right around the 46-yard line. About 5 yards on the screen.
Man, I don't trust my defense to continue this, so. Virginia Tech. Virginia Tech versus Miami 2011. He's going for it. Big hole. He might take it to the house. He runs into his own man. Down to the 14. Darian Hagan Jr., 32 yards.
Third first down of the drive. Defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
Bro, you mean 2009? The Nebraska game in 2009 was stupid. Freaking complete the long pass at the end of the game. My favorite Nebraska Virginia Tech game was the 1997 Orange Bowl. Go look it up, bro.
Tenth play of the drive.
Oh, he's going to roll out. He's going to be dropped. God damn.
And he can't get away from the pressure. The quarterback came out of nowhere.
Jeremy Madsen. Third and 20. So the Buffs going backwards, not the way they wanted to go. Jesus, how old are you? Right. Well, how old do I look, guys? That's the question, right? Oh, throws that to the seats. Oh, thank God he intercepted it. Could not come down with it. That's the end of the first quarter already? Man, that was quick. Kick the field goal. Get off.
It's up.
40 to 50. Kane just bringing the thunder.
Let's throw out to Reese now.
Later, Hokie.
Let's get you up to date on what's happening in some games with major BCS implications. What a statement this one makes. A complete blowout. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep.
Wow, big hole. Hokie for life must have looked at a profile of mine. I was 39. I'm no longer 39. Wishbone. Oh, wow. Dude, what a block they had on the edge. Holy smokes. Who's the most famous NFL player from Nebraska? Well, that went to Nebraska or is from Nebraska? Because that's two different things. You're going to have two different answers from me. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44. Long run, completely whiffed. He's going down.
When you combine his speed as a runner with the strength of the offensive line, you have the potential for some long runs.
I hate playing against these offenses.
A short yardage defense here.
Guys, let's tackle the freaking quarterback. Alright, so played. Because, like, probably the most famous guy from Nebraska that played in the NFL is Gale Sayers. He was from Omaha, but went to Kansas. I'm trying to think here. Most famous Nebraska football player. Will Shields. He's an NFL Hall of Famer. Offensive lineman. He was for the Chiefs. Irving Fryer was a number one pick. Oh, go Ryan.
He's taken down at the 27-yard line.
It's Texas. Do I know the name of the coach who coached at Iowa State Temple University? Rapper. He was from Omaha.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these
the
two.
The most famous player from Nebraska is Texas. What are you talking about, dude? McDaniel open. What's up, War God? How you doing, man? I know, I hate Texas, bro. So I get it, but like that's like childish, I guess. Ooh.
Makes it to the 47.
Whoa. Okay. Pitch the ball, bro.
And he hits him hard at the 50-yard line. That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat.
Yeah, either's Nebraska. Peace out. Texas will beat Oklahoma this season. Oh, that's big. That's a big statement. Pitch the ball. Jesus. I thought you were leaving, Hokie. Word God, it's been a long time since I've seen you in the chat, bro. How you been?
This is a very questionable play call here. I'm not sure I agree with it.
Is it, though? Is it, though?
Makes it to the 41.
Time to bust out some power football time. And this game has gone by fast.
first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line.
Bro, just throwing a big old pizza, man. What's up, ref? What, ref side? Man, how you been? It's been a minute. Glad you're checking out the stream, though, man. It's probably tough for you watching this. I'm playing with freaking Colorado. We pitched that late. Mac, it's going to have a first down. Man, if you guys haven't hit the thumbs up button yet, give this video a like. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, man, get that subscription. We're trying to get to 200 subscriptions on YouTube. We're at 140 right now. Dude, I was trying to throw to X. I think my controller is like screwing up tonight. Man. Not good. Not good. I'm just waiting for the coach to come in here, the rapper, to tell me to do something. Stop doing this. Again.
Defense looking for another sack in the second down and long situation.
Oh yeah, aren't you a truck driver? Is that right? You guys got to be busy. Oh, he's got him. Brown gets hit immediately, right at the sticks. It's going to be a first down, though, or close to a first down. Third down in inches. The O-line is all freshmen. Like, literally, they are all freshmen, so. We,
Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Have a lot of growing up to do. Third in inches. We're throwing it. Got him. Brown gets a first down inside the 10-yard line. Actually, you're going to mark him right at the 10. I didn't say he was born. I said he was from Omaha. Stat checker. Went to high school in Omaha. I would say he's from Omaha. Dude, nothing there. Hey DJ, that's what this thing is. Like, this year was kind of the growing year. I really felt like our team will hit its stride next year. I mean, we're going to throw in Dortch. We're going to have there's talent. We redshirted a ton of dudes. So this team's on the come. We just got to manage our way through it this year. Option. Flips it out there. Beautifully ran. Touchdown, Colorado. Let's go.
He made a great move to get into the end zone. There's a perfect play call. They look like they practiced that one a few times.
Yeah, there's a new book out called 24th and Glory. And it talks about, like, growing up in the late 50s and then early 60s in Omaha and all the amazing talent that was there, like Bob Gibson, Johnny Rogers, Bob Boone, NFL player, or not, an NBA player, Gale Sayers. They all used to play at the same park together. Imagine walking up into that park and like saying, I got next, and then having to deal with those athletes. Jesus, God almighty. Yeah, DJ, look what happens when he pitches the ball, bro. So Colorado up on Iowa State 10-7. Iowa State's running this offense, man. We're just fast-moving first half. You know, like 24 minutes into the game. Oof, gets it to the fullback, and he plows ahead for three. And that's going to do it. Colorado, big time. Big time. Score before the end of the half. Gets us the lead. And we get the ball coming out. New Orleans. Oh. Man. New Orleans is only about 3.5 hours from where I live right now. And I've been there a few times. I don't think I ever want to go back. I'm just not a fan of New Orleans. I'd go to a Sugar Bowl, and that's about it. There he goes. Like Bourbon Street, been there, done that, doesn't interest me. Here we go, 10-7. Come on, make a block, boys. Make a block. Let's go. Power Florida. I live between Fort Walton Beach and Pensacola. I live on Santa Rosa Island. From their own 24-yard line. Rapper, I don't really pay attention to the NFL offseason, to be honest. So you'd have more ideas than I would. Vaughn with the catch. Vaughn gets a first down. Oh, they're going to mark him short. So third down and one. Oh, we're going to go big. Let's go. F-slot big. And we will run speed option. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. It's the water. It's the freaking sewer. The fact that everyone pukes and that they, oh, it's so gross there. He's not going to get the first down. He lost a yard. Wow. Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the pass. I'm going for it. We aren't caring tonight at all. No cares given. Orlando's fun. I had a trip planned to Orlando before COVID hit. Oh, big hole. Matt cuts it outside. The freshman gets eight. DJ, top-notch observation. Love it myself. When it's in flight, man. Oh, so pretty. Big hole here. There goes Mac again. He's got eight more. And they make the stop around the 46-yard line. But it's PCN. That's where I live. It's beautiful, man. I don't think I'd ever live anywhere else. 2 yards to go. Orlando, man. That's just... It'd be fun to live there and go to Magic games. Oh, big hole. Now Colorado's really crossed them up on this spread option stuff. I mean, do you blame him? Being outside in this weather, man. Like today I went paddle boarding. It's like 80 degrees. Water's nice. Ooh, I shouldn't have spent. Not close enough to, but not too close to. Yeah. I bet that gets annoying. That's one thing I know about Orlando is, like, if you hit it the wrong time, bro. Traffic is stupid. Oh, look at that. Great blocking on the double ISO. 9 yards for Brandon Bolden, the senior. I mean, you got to deal with the traffic, but it's like, and then everyone's like, Orlando, do you like to go to Disney World? Do you like to go to Epcot? Do you like to go to... I'm sure it gets old. I mean, those are fun places and all. I love going to them with my family, but... Man, there's a lot of other things to do in Orlando. Colorado is up a field goal. Get outside. Good block. Got the first down. So Colorado just eating this clock away. Not giving Iowa State any opportunity to run their stuff. That's how we do it here.
From the 11-yard line, first down.
I don't even know what the Magic Gathering is. Like, oh, he threw a pick. Oh, we got so lucky. Man, if you haven't followed the channel on Twitch, hit that follow button. If you have not subscribed yet on YouTube, man, hit that subscribe button. Hit the thumbs up. Appreciate all the people in here already. All the likes we have. I don't even know how many we have. I can't even see it right now. Draw. Mac got the outside. Cuts inside. He's down. He's in. Touchdown. 11 yards. What a cutback. Nice run. Who's the best Colorado team? Well, it's CU, first off. Colorado's way better than Colorado State.
And he converts the extra point.
Let's get this in here. Another defensive stop, and we can put an end to this. What was the prediction earlier? What's up, Squinty? Man, it's been a while, bro. It's all right, man. Quick games, man. These option offenses, clock runs.
There's got to be some sense of urgency.
I need my offensive coordinator back, though, bro. We've lost three games already this year. Oh, Colorado's defense is all over him.
Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Oh, I'm sure, bro. It's good. I don't even think about finals anymore. At least you're done, though, right? You got summer school or are you working? Would the win put me back in the top 25? I don't know, man. The loss to Nebraska really hurt. We'd be 6-3. Iowa State, I mean, this will put us, I think, second in the division. But Nebraska's got a stranglehold. We need some massive help. 3rd and 14.
They're trying to stop the run here with the goal line defense.
Ooh, that was almost picked off. Oh, number 26 should have had that. Squinty says, I got a final in 6.5 hours. I should. What's the final in? Let's do a study session right now. Dynamics? Are you like an engineer?
You take what you can get.
Oh, man. My wife's an engineer. She was. Then she said, F this.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6.
And now we own a business that allows me to play on the beach every day. Let's go. Colorado just absolutely handling the Cyclones. This is what I needed. I needed this tonight. There for 8 hours. Bro, it's like the people she worked with We're just not cool. Not cool. But not like that they were jerks. They lacked a lot of like basic social skills. I can't explain it. Engineers are just tough people to hang out with. Ooh, got the pitch off. Wow, gutsy. I remember spending time like going to pick her up from like study sessions and stuff, and I was like, who are all these nerds? Here I'm in the teacher's college. It's like, yeah, first down, Brown. Ooh, Colorado's got it going tonight, boys. Bro, thermodynamics, that sounds like stupid. The thing is, like, those engineering courses, you're going to use that stuff. There's so many college classes that I didn't ever use. Even, like, the teaching classes. Like, man, that stuff you learn in a teacher's college, they don't teach. It doesn't help you day one when you walk in there. Like, oh, what a cut. My first day teaching. Yeah, it's a USB mic. This is some generic thing. Oh yeah, like my first day teaching, like I student taught at like this super affluent, well-to-do school, and then that district had a hiring freeze. So I had to go find a job for a year, and then I came back to that district my second year, and I'm not kidding you, the very first day I taught at an inner city school in Kansas City, Kansas, which is the rough part of Kansas City. And the first day, first period, I was teaching eighth grade U.S. history. The first day of class, there's a knock on the door, and I go and answer it. Fullback, look at that, rumbling for seven. I answer the door, and it's the principal and two police officers. And they're like, hey, I'll make up the student's name. Is Johnny there? His name was not Johnny. And I'm like, yeah, I think so. I mean, it's first period now. I haven't really taken roll. You guys are here like right away, right? And I'm like, you need him for something? And they're like, yeah. Can he come with me? What a throw. Touchdown, Colorado. And so... Johnny's here, and then I look at Johnny, and I taught on the third floor of this old school building, and he looks at me, looks at the door, looks at the window, looks at the door, looks at the window, and I didn't know him. Like, I had no relationship with this kid. It was the first day of school. I couldn't pick him out. I didn't know anything about him. Thanks, DJ. And lo and behold, like, the kid like wants to jump out the window, and I tell him, I go, Johnny, do not jump out that window, just go with them. And he's like, Mr. A, I can't go with them, I can't. I'm like, just go with them, you jump out the window, it's gonna end bad. So again, first day ever teaching. And so he's gone. Like, they take him away. I go down after school and I go to the principal and I say, hey, am I going to see him anymore? And they're like, no, never. And I'm like, what? And they're like, nah, he's been arrested. He's not going to come back to this school. And I'm like, well, what'd he do? Again, eighth grader. He was the driver in a drive-by shooting. And I was like, damn. I was there for 1 year, and the stuff that I could write a book about the stuff that happened in that 1 year. I mean, I was out, couldn't do it anymore. So yeah, that's my life, man. That was the first experience teaching, and Rutledge just destroyed that man. Yeah, that is a true story. Hey guys, I'm chatting with both Twitch and YouTube right now, so if you don't understand what's going on, I'm probably talking to the other chat right then. No disrespect to either platform, just have both going at the same time.
Second and five.
Yeah, that was a true story, man. Eighth grader in the drive-by. It was an eye-opener for sure. Oh, that was almost caught three times. Cole Bryant, do you think they'll make a new NCAA football? I don't think so. I think it's done. With the new NIL, they almost need a union for that to happen, and I don't know if they'll make one. All right, Squinty, man. Good luck on your final, bro. I hope everything's go well. Aw, good play. Oh, the fullback still rumbling. Finally tripped up to the 40, 28 yards. All right, bro. Well, I appreciate you stopping in, Squinty. Yeah, PCN, that it was wild. I had also another. Okay, so I coached basketball at that school. And I had this player. His name was Didi. That's his real name. I took him home after practice one time, and it was like February, super cold, and he was going to walk, and it was starting to snow, and I was like, bro, I'll take you home. And so I took him home, and I get to his house. I pull in this like apartment complex that is like the most sketch place I've ever been in my life. And I'm like, Didi, is it okay if I come in here? You know, like, I don't look like you guys. And he's like, ah, oh, coach, it's fine. We're good. Oh, good ball. He dropped it. So I take him in there, and I'm like, how come your apartment's all dark? And he's like, oh, my mama's not home. I'm like, where's she at? And he's like, oh, I don't know. I think South Carolina. I'm like, wait, what? And I was like, well, who's taking care of you? And he's like, oh, my brother. I was like, where's your brother? Oh, he hasn't been around. And this is like on a Wednesday. He's like, he hasn't been around since like last Thursday. I'm like, wait a second. Who the hell's taking care of you, bro? And he's like, I'll find food on my own. I'm like, what are you going to eat tonight? And he's like, I'll just have some baked beans. And I'm like, bro, get in the car. We're going to Burger King. I took that kid to Burger King, and I let him pick. I said, pick whatever you want. Get whatever. I don't even care. Whatever you want, bro. And that kid devoured food. And it was like a moment where I just realized, like, man, there's so much craziness in this world. He's got to do the right thing. Help people out. But yeah, that's my story time. Story time by Summit. Oh man. Play action. Get back here, dude. Come on. We caught that. Let's go. And a face mask to boot. Can we talk about what my defense has done today? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you hear the stories. And here's the thing. Like, those kids are some of the coolest kids in the world. They've been dealt, like, the shittiest hand possible. And it's a generational thing. And it's hard to get out of that. But, you know, I mean, I have a master's in school administration. Like, I was a principal for a couple years. I had to get out of it. Couldn't do it anymore, man. Did I hear how bad Des Moines, Iowa, and Rock Island, Illinois was? What are you referring to, bro? I hadn't heard of that. I mean, are you talking weather-wise? Like, tornadoes and stuff? Or are you talking about school district? Because there's nothing in schools that surprises me. Nothing. When we opened our business and I got over the fact that my wife told me that my salary wasn't needed anymore. I first it was a shock to me. And then I miss education. In fact, I've been asked by the school here in Florida since I moved here, and I coach basketball at the high school. They asked me to be a PE teacher, so I'm probably going to do that once COVID all gets over with, but we'll see. This defense tonight is absolutely stunning. Man, if you're in the chat and you haven't hit the thumbs up button, man, I want to see all these people in here tonight hitting that thumbs up button. I don't even know how many we got. Second 17. Bro, I'm reading everything. Absolutely reading everything coverage-wise. Like I said, ref side, I don't doubt it one bit. Not one bit.
Just over 2 minutes in the game.
But like the whole genesis of this conversation about education is like they don't teach you that stuff. Carter. Oh, he almost picked it off. They don't teach you any of that stuff. You just got to go like basically fly by the seat of your pants. Like for real. It's insane. Like I saw a dude in that KCK, here's another story. At that Kansas City, Kansas school, I saw a security guard straight up Goldberg spear a student who had a gun in his waist pocket. Like, bro, he ran to the fire. He Goldberg'd that kid, folded him in half. Bro, DJ, you don't understand what I built at Air Force. That was the school I was at before Colorado. They are the freaking truth. Mac, running over dudes. Nine more, over 100 yards, three touchdowns. Did the Nebraska game, the loss in Lincoln, wake up the Buff defense? Finally, after all these weeks? Or are they just playing an offense that is just so trash? Oh, look at this. He gets 10 more. Man, we got 6 likes tonight, man. Much love. I love this, bro. Things are starting to finally get going, man. From the 20-yard line, first down. DJ is my dude. He's been in this chat all week. All weekend. Did I enjoy being a principal? I mean, there's some funny stories. But, no, I was more of a... I enjoyed the classroom way more. I mean, I'm not going to brag, but I was pretty good. I won gets away. I won a few awards. Was that on ref side? Was that on HBO? I think I do remember that. KPO, that's the baseball league, right? Do I live in Nebraska? No, I live in Florida. I wish I could do my own business. Man, if you're an engineer, you can do consulting. Do I think Lovie Smith will turn Illinois around? Well, I mean, depends on what the expectations are. Oh, he's not going down. What's the expectations? Yeah, Florida's a big place, though. Your principal is very annoying. Well, principals have a job to do, man.
They're not going to cater to everybody, you know what I mean? Should I kick this? I think I'm going to kick it just to add it up. Let's go. 34-7. Colorado hammers Iowa State. Let's go, Buffs. They win a night game. We had some recruits in. Mac Ryan, 21 carries, 115 yards, 3 touchdowns. I remember who asked about the mic. I think it was Refside asked about the mic earlier. Yeah, the mic itself is just a generic mic, and then I went on Amazon and bought like a boom that, you know, brings the mic in. I have some filters that are supposed to be delivered tomorrow. They're gonna be on the mic, but yeah, it's just a generic mic. But... love Squinny, the offensive coordinator. He's always saying, get more points, baby. Get more points. True. And the Buffs, we're bowl eligible. Let's go. And we have the best recruiting class we've had in a long time in Colorado coming in. Obviously, it's only my second year there, but we do have some dudes coming in. All right. No turnovers. Ref side. You might be a little behind, but it's an old documentary, right? Bangin' in Little Rock. It's old, and I think it was on HBO, and it's like a white dude that like went in, and I remember this. I don't remember all the the part I remember is like this white dude who's trying to learn about all these gangs, like says something to one of the gangs, calls one like a bro or something like that, and like they get pissed. And did they show like branding? Like, did they show dudes getting branded? Might have been, yeah. Shoot, I don't remember. If it's the one I'm thinking of, it's like probably, I was probably like, it's probably 15 years ago, 25 years ago, maybe 20 years ago. All right, big win for the Buffs. Let's see where we are. You guys think we're going to get ranked? Do you think we're going to get ranked? Kansas beat Oklahoma earlier. So that's going to be interesting. It took us a while to put them away last year. Les Miles has that team turned around. Hey, DJ, I got a quiz. Someone sent me an office quiz, and they got 20. What'd they get? 26 out of 30. I think I should share it with the chat. What do you guys think? It's a who said it quiz. DJ, I'm going to put it in the chat. Let's see here. See if it comes through. There you go. The rapper 10,000. That's an extremely shallow, like, response. A majority of the teachers. So a majority means over half of the teachers and half of the principals are annoying and bitter towards certain students. I mean, what does that even mean? Bro, we got two. Look at that. John Ball. What a name. for a DB, John Ball. Is the game audio skippy? I don't know. I'm not hearing anything. Let's go take out a check at this. Did we get ranked? I didn't see. I have a feeling we're in trouble on some of these dudes. Eric Williams. God, if we can get him. Oh. Amos. I'm trying to break the lock, but Nebraska's going to steal him in week 10. I have a feeling. I want to get Mike so I can break the lock. You know what I mean? Samuel McCarty. Still pulling away. Gary Mackey. Visit. Damn it. Or to visit during a freaking bye week. That sucks. Rosario. Oh, that's... Why'd I exit out? Damn it. Rosario's a massive dude we need to get. Brian Simon. Let's go. Instant commit. Damn. Freaking Wisconsin jumped on him. 1,000 points back. That hurts. All right, we're going to throw 700 there. We're going to throw 700 there. We're not going to try to go after this guy. DJ, I want to see what you get. I won't end this stream until I see it. Freddie, not even going after him. Carlos Turner. All right, so we have 150 points left. Cook. Shoot, these guys all are terrible. We'll put them on this dude. Hey, later, Edward. Thanks for stopping in tonight, bro. Appreciate you. Hope you hit that thumbs up button. All right, let's take a look at the top classes right now. Colorado, they're up to number 4. We have 2 5 stars. Who'd we get? Oh, that's right. We got Clay Hill, number 1 strong safety in the country, and then Mr. Dortch gonna be another running back. He's probably gonna get a new name. We're probably gonna have to rename that guy. And again, I forgot to mention this, the kicker's taken care of already, but if you sub or donate to the channel, whether that be through, and I don't know why my Streamlabs is not sending the donation link on YouTube, but if you donate to the channel, you can have a recruit be renamed after you, and you get let's say DJ donates to the channel. I'm not saying DJ has to or needs to or anything like that, but let's say he donates to the channel. Maybe he knocks off the summit. The top donation is $5 right now. If you knock him off, he's the champion. If you knock him off, you get beat on the top of the mountain, your name's gonna replace his. And then I rename one of these recruits. You get to tell me what you want to look like, what position you want to be, and that's how we kind of roll. So that's kind of one of the cool things we do to try to incentivize, get the community to be part of the team, you know what I mean? We have a top 10 class. We have 10 commits. I like it. All right. So what do we look at here? Are we rated again? Number 24. We're back in it, baby. Back in it. Who's number one? Is it still Nebraska? I'd assume so, right? Yeah. Ooh, look at that. Nebraska and Michigan. Then there's Air Force. They get Army this week. Colorado checks in at number 24. They get a tough Kansas team. How good's Kansas? Kansas is 5-2.
Really?
Heisman watch? Any love for anybody? No. Ryan Carter. Syracuse, the fullback. Allen Heath. They won 38-26. That might have wrapped up the division. Let's take a look at the conference standings. I'm pretty sure that's it. Hey, bro, that's okay. So how many games does Nebraska have left? They have three left? It's a nine game. Oh, they have one, two, three, four. I gotta hope we can get some help there. We play three left. All on the road. That was senior night. The seniors went out with a bang. 34-7. Look at the losses we've had this year. 1-point loss. Texas. That was just depressing. Nebraska came up short. Ugh. Hey, you can't tell me. You can't tell me anything, bro. I need to take it myself. All right, man. That's it for me tonight. I think I'm going to stop the stream. I appreciate you guys stopping in this quick little stream tonight. Got KU next. Hopefully, we can get a dub there. I appreciate you guys. We had all the likes tonight. Didn't get any new subs. That's all right, man. We're going to just keep this thing going. Actually, it says we got one new sub, so I don't know who that is yet. It hasn't come through. But, man, I appreciate everybody. Hope you have an awesome Tuesday. And hopefully things start getting safer out here, man. Appreciate everyone. Hope you all have a good one. Save this all. All right. Peace out, everyone. You've got